In part one of this tutorial, we ran a workspace that was already provided with FME Server. But you'll want to be able to publish your own workspace in FME Server, and then run them. So let's learn how that's done. In this video, we will review and run a workspace in FME Workbench, publish the workspace to FME Server, run the workspace from FME Server Web User Interface, and finally, show the results page. Go ahead and open up the Community Mapping workspace in FME Workbench. It's a straightforward workspace that will be taking data from a filed geodatabase and writing it to the generic format. The generic format is very flexible and allows users to decide which format to write to when the workspace runs. It's been set up to write out to the Esri shapefile. We can confirm that by taking a look at the output format parameter. Let's run the workspace to make sure it works before publishing it to FME Server. In FME Workbench, go to File, Publish to FME Server. To connect to your FME server, enter your server URL. For this example, I'm going to use the localhost, and then connect with the username and password. We can use the default author username and author password. Next, select the repository and the workspace name. We will click on the New button to create a new repository. Let's call it Server Tutorial. Register the workspace with one or more services. Each service returns a translation result in slightly different formats. The data download service returns the results as a downloadable zip file. The data streaming service returns the results as a data stream. The job submitter service accepts and runs the workspace job requests. The KML network link returns a KML network link that can be used in Google Earth. And finally, the notification service allows for event-driven messaging. Check the data download service. You can leave the job submitter checked as well and then click Publish. The log file should confirm that the workspace was successfully published. Now open the FME Server Web User Interface and log in with the author username and author password. Our workspace appears in the Last Published Workspace section. Click Run Workspace. On the Run Workspace page, select the repository we just created, which is Server Tutorial. Once you do this, the workspace field below will automatically be published with the Community Mapping workspace. This is because it's the only one in the repository. The service dropdown shows the two services that we registered this workspace with. Let's pick Data Download. We will work with published parameters in the next part of this tutorial. For now, just click on Run Workspace. The translation was successful, with some summary information and a data download URL. Click on the URL to download the zip file, and then open it up to confirm that we have a number of Esri shapefiles as a result of our translation. Wouldn't it be great to give the user a choice of which format they would like their results in? We'll learn how to do that in the next part of this tutorial.